In this project, your students will design earthquake-resistant buildings using Google Science Journal, an app on your phone that can measure acceleration. Watch what happens if I attach the phone to this model building that is attached directly to the ground, or this piece of cardboard, and then shake the cardboard to simulate an earthquake. You can see that we get minimum and maximum accelerations of roughly 5 meters per second squared. Now, watch what happens if I put the house on these markers that act like rollers and allow it to slide relative to the ground. You can see that we have much lower minimum and maximum accelerations of less than 1 meter per second squared. This happens because the markers function similarly to a base isolation system in a real building that isolates the movement of the building from the movement of the ground, allowing the ground to slide back and forth under the building during an earthquake. However, this simple design is not perfect. For example, there's nothing stopping the building from drifting off to one side and falling off the markers. In this project, it will be up to your students to improve the design using common classroom materials. For example, you can add rubber bands to keep the house centered, but be careful, if the rubber bands are pulled too tightly, they can actually make the oscillations worse. You could add padded stoppers to both sides of the building that prevent it from rolling off the tracks. But again, be careful. If these stoppers are too close to the building or too hard, they could cause the spikes in the acceleration to increase. You can even get rid of the rollers entirely and try suspending the house using straws and string. Your students can use a combination of these methods or completely different ideas that they come up with on their own to try and reduce the peak accelerations felt by the building during a shake test. To view written instructions for this lesson plan, as well as thousands of other science and engineering project ideas, visit us online at www.sciencebuddies.org.